Hi, I'm Stephen Cronin and I'm going to show you today how you can improve your watercolours. But first, let's have a look at the materials. This is my palette and we've got ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, raw sienna, burnt umber and light red. Got my large Ron Ranson hake brush and 15x11 £130 Fabriano watercolour paper. So this is just clean water all over the paper. This will stop it from doing all crinkly and also soften the background with no hard edges. So I'm going to go, what should we use? A bit of umber, light red. Let's just see what that looks like. Bit of marine. More ultramarine, and there. Something like that. And I'm just going to see how the airs are just going everywhere. So all I'm doing, I'm just dipping the tips in the water just to bring all the airs back together. And then I'm going back to a bit of lemon yellow. This is just sort of foliage en masse that will hopefully look like leaves when it's all finished, without painting them all in individually one by one. Get down the bottom there. Right, it's getting a little bit darker now, so I'm introducing a bit of ultramarine, just darkening up a little bit, little shadowy areas here and there, and then I'll darken them again later, a bit further in the painting. So that's just a nice sort of background that we've got to work with. First thing I'm going to do next, a little brush, a bit of brown, a bit of blue, plenty of water. I'm going to put in some distant trees. So what I'm doing, just flick it up. Flick it up like that. Flicking down for the reflections, because this is all water at the bottom. It's like another... I quite like doing these sort of forest stream type ones. I'll have to try and do one. I keep meaning to do some painting outdoors. Take the paints down to Sutton Park or something. Rather than using photographs all the time. Now it's March, obviously the weather's just starting to warm up, so hopefully that'll become a possibility sometime soon. And it's just a case of trying to find somewhere private where people aren't walking past. I'm not used to painting. Obviously there's people watching this, but I'm not used to people watching in real life. So that's all those trunks. Now these are a few little, that's starting to dry there. You can see how that's going on a bit stronger. So just bring a few twigs and branches. Don't forget the reflections down the bottom. And then as the paper dries, the paint goes on stronger and stronger. And so you see how much stronger that's got on now compared to the ones behind. I got a bit frustrated then with that one. It just didn't seem to be working properly. A few more things going here and there. Don't forget these reflections down the bottom. A bit more water, a bit more brown, a bit more blue. I have to keep reloading the brush, doesn't hold as much obviously as the hake does. Bang these on a bit stronger. Again, keep popping those reflections in. And you see the darker you put it on, contrasting against the lighter air, it creates a more sort of dramatic effect. I've always gone more sort of mood and atmosphere rather than realism. As long as the elements are in the right place. I use photographs and there's trees here and water there. As long as it's all there about, it's, for me it's more about creating the mood, light and darks and drama and atmosphere sort of scenes than anything else. So that's like a sort of second layer of trees that I like to put on. And then the final one I put on with the hay. So what I might do next is, you see how the paper's stretched, it's coming away from the board. So I'm just going to re-clip it. This one's come away there. Put it tight against this piece of plywood I've got leaning against the easel. Just so that it's flat now, I'll pull that out again. And I'm making a bit of a meal of this. Just putting it too hard. Right, it should be good to go now. That's down there. So before I put the next layer of trees, I just want to put some sort of a few faint little trees. Working the where these trees go, not there, but down there. And just put down some reflections. A few more trees. Working out the land, the shape of the river. It's just coming in something like that. Just going to sort of flow along there. So it contrasts nicely. That's where it goes round. A few sort of little dark shadowy areas here and there. Let's put these other trees in then. So we want the strongest trees in there. So I'm doing this for a dark colour, so I'm going to bother cleaning the brush. What I'm going to do is just dip the corner into the water just to bring all the airs back together. And I'm just going to go burnt umber, ultramarine. Just enough water on the brush to hold all the airs together, so you get this nice chisel edge effect. So you want some trees up there. Popping those reflections in. So this bank's further away, and then this one's going to be a little bit close. So I'm just doing the furthest ones first. Can't see much more on this side. Let's just pop a few twigs and branches on this. So you're just deliberately putting that across that light area there, just to really show it up. Always looking for sort of maximum contrast. Just exploit it as best you can. Now, even if it's not there in reality, you've always got license to improve on your reference pictures. Something's coming off the top there. I might put just a bit of foliage on there in a minute. So I just want to put some big trees on the right hand side there. So there's going to be some rocks, some dark rocks down there. That's wet. Just scraping a few highlights. Just where the light's just catching the top of the rocks. And then from there we've got a big one leaning right over, leaning towards that sort of light area. To push that over to that lit area there, just to maximise the effect. And a few leaves going up, a few coming down. Don't forget the reflection, which I almost did then. That's just the reflection of that one. More water on the brush into this dark mix. A few more twigs and stuff on this side first before I put the foliage on. I think we need something there. Just stick another big tree up there. I think we need something just to give in this corner. Yeah, pop that reflection down. A few more. I'll pop a bit of foliage on this in a minute once I've finished putting the skeletons in. I want a bit of dry brushwork now, so I'm cleaning the brush in the water, and I'm just squeezing the water out, and then whatever's left in there. I'm going to put on the tea towel, just squeeze it out. So you've got a nice dry brush, just scuff it up a bit. Just so the reason for doing that is so you can get random leaf effects in the tree, so it's not nice and uniform and unnatural looking. So I'm just giving raw sienna, lemon yellow. Nice light bits of green hanging in the trees. Now I'll make them a bit darker in a minute by adding a bit of ultramarine, make them a bit dark, and then add a bit of Payne's grey to make them darker still. A few reflections even there in the water. What's this going to start? Ultramarine. It's got a few darker areas. Little reflections here and there. And then Payne's grey, make it darker still. Really dark green now. On these sort of darkening, sort of shadowy areas. So you because the brush is so dry, now I can just go a bit crazy on the paper, and now I'm not gonna block in too much. There's not too much paint gonna come off. Foliage, I think, is it? Just get some little shadowy sort of effect down there. You see, because the brush is now really, really dry, I can go like this, and I know only little bits of paint are going to come up. I'm not going to completely ruin it. Right, so I think, I mean, you know, just to strengthen these banks now. So, see how the paint's all, the brushes are all, hairs are all scuffed up. I'm just dipping, I'll just dip the tips in just to bring all the hairs back together so we've got a nice sharp edge. Taking the excess off. And then I can just go, a bit of burnt umber, a bit of ultramarine. Now let's just define some of these banks now. We got smoke coming out of here like this. Rocks here and there. Right, just define the left hand side. So I'm sort of coming something like like that. So they've got sort of a lot of water sort of swishing around like that. Okay, it's just little rocks here and there. A lot of people say, how do you do rocks? If you just put the paint on, not too much water, not too, you know, it's a fairly thick mix, I think. And you just go straight in, too, you just go straight, you've got to wait for it to dry. But what I might do now is, I'm just going to clean the brush. Again, squeeze that water out. And I just want to, all I'm looking for is just a sort of clean, damp edge. Something like that. And then I'm just going to, what I'm doing, I'm just dabbing here and there, and it just looks like I'm sort of trying to sort of blend the water, where the land meets the water, just sort of blend it together. And just try and create like little ripple effects on the water. That's pretty much the right hand side of the bank. So let's do a few more I'm just going to straighten that up. Just get it nice and straight, like a chisel edge again. I'm going to do a few more on the left hand side. Just tapping, just dab. And just trying to blend where the water meets the edges of the banks. And again, it just looks like little ripples or just little reflections here and there. Trying to make it a bit more natural. I think that's enough of that. Right. So, next we've got shadows. So, I'm just going to mix a bit of brown, bit of red, bit of blue. Nice little shadowy colour. Enough there. Right, now, so let's just stick that. I'm going to pretend that that's the sun there, that bit of white. So I'm going to start with these ones here. I'm just going to follow the line down and just get that shadow across there, just darken that a little bit. Not sure what that was meant to be. Still on the other side, so I just follow that around like that. Follow it around. Darken that a little bit. Made a mess of that. Shadowy areas there on the basically, you're just trying to get that sort of light against dark effect. Sort of dramatise it as much as you possibly can. Shadow in this area. So I'm just going to pause it now and you're going to stand at the back of the room and have a look at it. Yeah, I'm just had a look at it and I'm pretty happy with that now. I'm gonna leave that now as it is. So all I want to do next, the only thing I want to add, I'm just gonna stick a little bird. I'm going to put three little birds flying there. I'm going to leave it at that. Just stick my name down there. Right then. Let's see what that looks like with the mount on. So here we have our finished painting, all mounted up. So if we go in and have a closer look at it, to be honest, I quite like this one. I know I've done a few in recent times that I haven't liked, but I think this one, I like the way you've got the sort of light areas and then you've got the sort of dark areas. I think it works, the balance is just right. I think what I like about the background as well, I start with raw sienna and then I put the ultramarine in. The last few I've done, I haven't put the ultramarine. I think the sky looks a little bit better without it, to be honest. So you can see I was trying to capture this light coming through and sort of reflected off the water down the centre.
And then if you remember at the start, I was just brushing in lemon yellow from either side. And you can see the reason being, it just sort of looks like a sort of whole mass of foliage in the background, rather than painting it in all, you know, individual leaves, just like here, a bit yellow there, a bit yellow where, it just looks like a whole mass of trees and bushes in the distance. And then to help try and create depth, I always put the trees, try and get them in three layers. So you've got the most distant ones that you can just about see, put in using the rigger brush while the paper's still pretty wet. Then you've got, see like these ones for example, they look really far away. Then you've got the ones that were put in a little bit when the paper's dried a little bit, bit stronger, like maybe this one here, this one that goes up. So it creates your sort of middle sort of depth. And then in the foreground, put in with the hake brush, big strong trees there, help push, bring these ones to the front and push all those ones right the way back. Same on this side, you've got these two trunks going up there. And also, remember to make the most of the light by putting the darks against light. So you can see I've deliberately come off just across that branch, across the light there for maximum effect. So where you've got light, you have to have shade. So I've tried to really put this area here in shadow. Don't forget to reflect it again in the water. Same on the other side, you've got the light coming through here. All these areas in shadow here. Just, you can see where I've just used the card just to scrape out the top, just to try and create the effect of light just striking the top of it, and then you've got shadows behind. Well, that'd be like that. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Any questions, please ask. Don't forget to keep practicing. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you again soon.